let's begin by writing a query to fetch a new cart. We'll fetch this cart by ID, and we'll actually pass the ID of the cart within the query here. And then we'll go ahead and create a name for the query, and we'll pass a GraphQL variable inside of the query itself as $ID, and then the type that you pass into the query must match that of the cart query. Then if we pass ID to the ID and run the query, it won't work. And this is because we need to actually pass the ID within the query variables. And GraphQL Playground makes this really easy. It is worth mentioning that the variable names don't need to match the names of the input types or any of the fields on your query. Here we have hello world instead of ID. And as long as we pass that into the query variable, it all works. You can also use GraphQL variables with mutations. So let's write a new mutation to add a cart without any variables to see what this looks like first. So the query will be to add a new item to a cart, and we'll give it a price, name, and the cart ID and item ID. So let's take that same mutation, but now we'll update it to use the GraphQL variables. And we'll need to change a few things with the add item mutation. We'll need to give it some arguments in the query name here, and these will be the variable names. The cart ID must match the type that is inside of the GraphQL schema, and you can find that inside of the docs. This can be an input type, a scala type, or it can be an enum. In this case, add item cart input, cart ID is a ID. Then we'll pass the actual item ID, which is of the scala type ID, and the name, which is of type string. And the string is optional here. Then we'll pass the price, which is required, and this is of the type int. Then all that's left to do is update the actual mutation, add item, and pass the variable names to those input types. Then, so we can successfully run the mutation, we need to pass the query variables. And inside of GraphQL Playground, this is really easy and also applies if you're using GraphQL. This is really easy inside of GraphQL Playground, GraphQL, and most GraphQL client libraries will provide the ability to pass variables within the function call to your GraphQL endpoint. So with those queries added, we can now run that mutation. Now let's explore writing a mutation that accepts one variable. And this variable will be the input type addToCartInput. So here, if we open the docs and have a look at the type that is required for the addToCart mutation, we can see that the input type is addToCartInput. So we can pass this to the variable. Then we can pass input to input. And we can call all of the GraphQL fields to return with that mutation. But in order for this to work, we need to pass the entire input type. And because this is the entire input type, you have to satisfy all of the required fields here. And you can also pass any additional ones, such as description. So let's update the query variables to include description or any one of the other types on that input type object, and we'll pass it to the variable. Don't forget to update the query to return that if you want to see if that was successful or not.